So I will let Eric, since he is closest to me, introduce the trio.
All right. Hello, everyone. So, that's a little better. So my name is Eric Gardner, and I am a freshman clarinet performance major here at the University of South Carolina. Here we have Chase Miller, who is a music ed major, and Henry King, who's also a clarinet performance major, and all three of us are freshmen. And today we're going to be playing for you a trio written by Mozart. It's his 439th piece in the Kurzweil system. It's a serenade originally written for three basset horns, which was a kind of interesting variant of the clarinet, which is no longer used today. So if you get a chance to go look up the basset horn, I highly recommend you do it. But this is a modern transposition for modern clarinets. And we're going to play the first movement, the third movement, and the fifth movement.
Thank you.
second. They are originally a freshman quintet, and things transpired in the last 2 weeks to make them a trio. Some things beyond everybody's control to become a trio for 2 weeks and then return to quintet status next week. It has nothing to do with COVID, so, but just other things. So I have to commend these three for digging up Mozart and pretty much preparing it this past week for today. So good job. So next I'm going to do three individual performances. The first will be Eric. He'll come back up on stage and I'll allow him to introduce the piece and then he'll go ahead and perform for you, and then we'll have two sophomores come up and do a couple of solo pieces also. So these are three solo pieces, originally solo pieces for clarinet, nothing else that they perform for you all. I think you'll enjoy them. They're a wide variety of pieces. One that you probably know, or many of you may know, that Eric is playing. It's more standard, but the other two are not as standard. So I'd be surprised if any of you know the two that will follow. But three very, very good works. One note about the basset clarinet, or basset horn, actually, two different instruments. Basset horn, the piece, the trio that was originally written for three basset horns. You will hear the wind ensemble performance, I think, this evening when they're doing the Mozart Grand Prix, and that includes two basset horns in that. So you'll hear the original instrumentation that Mozart wrote for that. Which includes two basset horns, and you'll see and hear those played tonight by our students with the ensemble performance. So I'm sure you will know that it's one of Mozart's best works. So, anyways, without further ado, I will introduce to you Eric.
Hello again. I've already introduced myself to you, so I won't bother going over that whole spiel again, but yeah, I'm Eric, and I'm going to be playing Heinrich Sudermeister's Capriccio for clarinet A, and this is a more contemporary piece, so if you're not familiar with different contemporary works, this may be a little bit unusual to you, but I find that it is a very nice piece. Now, the person who wrote it, Heinrich Sudermeister, was actually the brother of a famous Swiss medical journalist and social advocate. Oh goodness, I forgot his first name, but his last name was Sudermeister, because you know, they were brothers, that's how these things work. Yeah, Heinrich Sudermeister, he was a Swiss composer in the kind of early and mid 20th century, and this particular piece was written in 1947. So without further ado of me just babbling on, here is Sudermeister's Capriccio for clarinet.
Thank you.
you play that on the A-Clarinet, correct? But I do assign it for a lot of students that don't own an A-Clarinet, so working on B-flat. So since it's not worth piano, it's very accessible for anybody who doesn't have an A-Clarinet. So next we have Jesse Winslow, and I'll let Jesse come up and introduce his piece and talk.
Jesse Winslow. I'm a sophomore clarinet student here at the University of South Carolina. I went to Clover High School. I graduated 2 years ago, obviously. And today I'm going to be playing the Ida Gostkowski solo sonata for clarinet. This piece was written in 1986 for the International Clarinet Society, and Ida is a student of Oliver Messiaen, which, if you know his music, they're very similar. But this piece features a lot of modal transposition and extended techniques. There's flutter tonguing, really, really, really extreme altissimo. So, enjoy.
Jesse, nice job. Good job. So Jesse mentioned some extended techniques. You mentioned flutter tonguing. I don't know if you caught the flutter tonguing in there, and if you don't know what flutter tonguing is, it's when you just flutter your tongue against the roof of your mouth and you play. So there were some blocks. You do that. Some people can do that. Some people can't flutter tongue. If you can't flutter tongue, a lot of people do the growling thing where you just like yell at the same time when you play. So I don't know if you were able to tell that over Zoom, but he also used circular breathing in that. I don't know if you caught that. There were some sections in there where he circular breathes. And I'm not going to demonstrate that to you because I don't do it well. I'll just be honest with you. It's not something I've pursued much in my life, which I haven't felt a need for it. But in a piece like this, I could probably pursue it more. I have not played this piece. In fact, this is the first time I've taught it. And it's a fantastic piece. And then there was one at the end where it was a timbre trill, and that's when you're just changing the timbre of a note on a trill, and you're actually changing the pitch. So, so you just play a note and you find a key that you can trill that's not going to change the note, but it'll change the timbre. So a lot of contemporary, more contemporary music uses timbre trills. So, anyways, if I'm not mistaken, I'm not 100% on this. I think Gajkowski also studied, not with just Olivier Messiaen, but Igor Stravinsky earlier in their life too. So you can hear a lot of that in their music. Anyways, so moving on, we have Marianne. She's going to play next. She'll be our last performance. And I'll let her introduce herself and what she'll be playing.
Music performance major. I'll be playing for you Anton Gergen, Skupishev number one. He's still alive. his piece was written within the past, I don't know, like 50 years, and it's a part of three Skupishevs that he wrote along with a lot of other pieces, including a really cool concerto. So, I'm going to enjoy. Thank you.
Great job. Very nice. One piece.